السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Why you are less than 30? Our core group was about 40 to 50 young leaders who made the history to make the change. They never felt cold. They never out. Put your hand out. You're not feeling cold. You're not in Siberia. You're not in, you're not whatever it is. I was not invited, by the way. I landed from heaven. I was coming to another event and I thought that the event is here. I walked in to have breakfast, free coffee, and I found these two events. So here we talk. What do you want to do? Why you are here today? Why you are here today? To learn, to listen, or to do? What to do? What to do? You, come next to me. Come on. Tell me what do you want to do? I'm not here to speak. Don't giggle or I'll giggle you. Hands. What do you want to do? Where is the microphone? There's some microphone here. Yeah, behind you. Go and get it. I know this place very well. I used to come here years and years and years. I'm not sure if somebody remember me. What do you want to do?
Put what I learn into action. Who has a mess?
Oh, very nice. I like the hairstyle. Which one is better? go on.
To put what I learn into action when I go back to my local community.
Give me what you want to do. Local community needs what?
Leadership.
What do you mean by leadership?
I'll talk about that.
No, you have to respond. Now you are in an exam. And give me the paper, sister. And there's a question here. If you answer, you succeed. If you don't answer, you fail. If you are not prepared for any stupid question, any stupid comment, we are not leaders. Leaders are not just beautiful faces or long beard or jalabiya or genji beard, is that right? Or kohl in the eyes, mascara. This is not the leadership. Kohl for the men, not for the women. It's allowed for the women, but men are doing it. It's the only sunnah they are following the Prophet ﷺ. Many sunnah in the Prophet ﷺ, but they decide to have the henna and the kohl. So what else? Make a change. Answer the question. Even if you answer wrongly, you succeed.
What was the question again?
What do you want to do? You said I want to become a leader.
And future the younger generations.
Yeah, yeah, I'm young like you. I'm a funny man. Okay,
yes,
I'll save you. Yes, I'm. He admitted that I'm a funny man. Okay. Brother, young brother. You. Yes, yes, come on. Because I will be elevated to rise to stand next to you. What do you want me to do to the community when you go home?
Help them.
How? Anything. How can you help the kids?
Give them iPad.
Give iPad. Very good. Oh, no, no. Give them iPad. Very good. To do what?
Play.
Play to. And after playing, to do what with the iPad?
To learn.
To learn. That's what I'm saying. Do you know something called 3D printing? Do you use it?
No.
No? Who use it? Raise hands. Three. Who does not know anything about it, raise hands. It is a new technology. When you teach your children, mothers, instead of playing on the Facebook and social media, they create design. They create something like chair, like table, they started playing games. He said, iPad for play. Now, I know, but actually came first as play.
Yeah.
Do you like Musalah?
Yeah.
Do you like Chris? What's
Cristiano
Ronaldo? No, he's not here. How do you know Cristiano Ronaldo? It's haram that the woman watch football. You know the Maulana? We'll tell you that. Okay, is that right?
Of course.
You won't be saved. Here you go. Thank you. So use the opportunity to be with the people who can help you. Building community blocks is not a joke. You know, this institution, you are standing in it, people spend tens of years to raise the fund, to build it, to produce generations like you who do not appreciate what the elders have done to the community. We are dead meat. We are what? Dead meat. You know what? Because the people who started the movement in UK are the people who did not speak English, who were workers, taxi drivers. They came 50, 60, 70 years ago. Now we are sitting in these prestigious places. And we don't like the food. We don't like the service. And we don't like even the people who actually, they don't speak English. They are ignorant. They are your grandfather, my brothers and my sisters, who made you to stand in the university because they love you. Let me give you a story of one of the greatest men in a country like Egypt, because people come to talk to you about Pakistan and India and Bangladesh. So I'll take you away. A young girl like you, a farmer, was not educated, was a farmer, and she married to somebody. And during her pregnancy, he left her away and ran away. He ran away from her. This was the end of the 1890 or 1880, I can't remember exactly at the time. Then the woman went with her mother to have the baby. Then the ignorant young Egyptian farmer wanted to educate her son. She was determined. Your role is crucial. She's not just a beautiful faces. Okay, they are not objects. She decided to educate her son. He became very good students in the primary school. At that time, when you have your certificate of the primary school, you'll be eligible to work. So the father came to try to take the son because he will create money for him. So the mother ran away from the village and went to a place called Alexandria, the second largest city in Cairo, in Egypt. And she wasn't hiding. She did work all the dirty jobs, cleaner, doing everything, because she had a dream. Because you had a dream for your son. Because you have a dream for your children. You know what? This son became a doctor, a medical doctor. And he was brilliant. Then he was qualified as a surgeon. Then the Sultan at that time, or the king at that time, they called him Khedewi at that time, had a cancer and nobody would be able to treat him. They went to have a consultation with this man to bring him. He operated on the king, or what they call him at that time. The king was so impressed because he was cured. From an ignorant young farmer who ran away with a kid, and she was working as a house cleaner, to a doctor who was treating the Sultan or the king or the Khedewi. Then not only that, he became the first Secretary General of the Egyptian Medical Syndicate. And then they gave him the title of Pasha. Who made the Pasha? It's you. It is you. You got it? You got it? If the woman have a dream, she can make history. But you should have a dream as well. To keep history writing behind you. Let history run after you. Because every day you have a new milestone that you are covering. So we are not here to listen. We are here to think, to act, to deliver, and make that change. Clear? Clear? Is my 5 minutes up? Jazakallah khair. I love you. And thank you for the free, what do you call, toast. And the eggs, which I cannot be able to take the skin out of it or the crust out of it.